Now, the next topic that we are going to start is how we can find equation of a straight line in case of complex number. We already know how we can find equation of a straight line in case of real numbers. We used to have parametric equation for a straight line, non-parametric equation for a straight line. Then we even used to define condition for collinearity, for finding the area of a triangle, and so on, lots and lots of properties. We are going to derive all these properties even in case of complex number, and we will even discover that most of the properties resemble or are like similar to the equation in case of a real numbers. So let us start. Let us first try to write the parametric equation for a straight line in terms of parameter t. So my first topic is parametric equation of a straight line. So I am first writing the equation directly, then we will try to prove the equation even. So the parametric equation for a straight line in terms of parameters t is given by t into z1 plus 1 minus t into z2. T into z1 plus 1 minus t into z2. Let us try to prove this equation. For example, I have a line joining two points z1 and z2. This is my point z1, this is my point z2. Let us say any point, there is any point r with f(x, z) lying on this line joining z1 and z2, and let us say this point divides my line joining z1 and z2 in the ratio of t is to 1 minus t. So by the application of section formula, I can always write that the coordinates of z are t into z2 plus 1 minus t into z1 upon t plus 1 minus t. When I solve this equation, I am going to get this equation, which is the parametric equation for a straight line. Now, this is here we have derived parametric equation for a straight line. Now, let us try to another equation, the same equation for a straight line, but in not in case of any parameter. So I call that as non-parametric equation. So the non-parametric equation for a straight line can be derived by solving this determinant, that is z bar 1, z1, z1 bar 1 and z2, z2 bar 1 equals to 0. When I solve this determinant, what I get is z into z1 bar minus z2 bar plus z bar into z1 minus z2 plus z1 z2 bar minus z2 z1 bar is equals to 0. This equation is termed as non-parametric equation for a straight line. Now, if three points z1, z2 and z3 are collinear, then they must, then both, all the three z1, z2 and z3 must satisfy this equation. So I am replacing z by z3 in this determinant. I can write z3, z3 bar 1, or I will write this as this way, z1, z1 bar 1, z2, z2 bar 1, z3, z3 bar 1 is equals to 0. This is the condition for three points z1, z2 and z3 to be collinear. So we say that for three points z1, z2 and z3 to be collinear, the value of this determinant has to be equal to 0. Here we have derived equation of a straight line in terms of parameter t, and this is the non-parametric equation for a straight line. Now based upon these two equations, let us try to write a general equation for a straight line in case of complex number. The general equation for a straight line in case of complex number is given
by a bar z plus a z bar plus b equals to 0, where b is a real number and a is any complex number.
Now once again repeating, the general equation for a straight line for complex number is given by a bar z plus a z bar plus b equals to 0, where a is any complex number and b is a real number.
The slope, or in case of complex number, we define two types of slope for a straight line. One is a complex slope and one is a real slope. So for this general equation, complex slope is defined as minus coefficient of z bar upon coefficient of z, which in this case would be equals to minus of a bar upon a.
I'm repeating once again,
minus of a upon a bar.
I'm repeating once again, the general equation for a straight line in case of complex number is given by this equation a bar z plus a z bar plus b equals to 0, where a can be a any complex number and b is a real number. Now in case of complex number, a straight line can have two slopes. One is defined as a complex slope and one is defined as a real slope. So the complex slope for a straight line is defined as minus coefficient of z bar upon coefficient of z. So in this equation, coefficient of z bar is a and coefficient of z is a bar.
So the complex slope of a line is defined as minus a upon a bar, and the real slope is defined as minus real of a, minus real of a upon imaginary of a. Now we all know that real of a can be defined as a plus a bar, and imaginary of a can always be defined as a minus a bar upon iota.
So this is the definition for real slope of a, which is minus iota a plus a bar upon a minus a bar. So here we have defined equation of a straight line in three forms. One in case of a parameter t, where we get this equation, that is t into z1 plus 1 minus t into z2 equals to 0. In case of non-parametric equation, we can get the equation of a straight line by solving this determinant. And what we have derived from this equation is that if z1, z2 and z3 are three collinear points, then both z1, z2 and z3 must satisfy this determinant. So this is the condition for collinearity of three points. And last, the general equation of a straight line can be given as a bar z plus a z bar plus b equals to 0, where complex slope is defined as coefficient of z bar upon coefficient of z, and real slope is defined as minus real of a upon imaginary of a, and which turns out to be minus iota a plus a bar upon a minus a bar. Now let us discuss this general equation of a straight line more. We have seen that the general equation of a straight line is given by a bar z plus a z bar plus b equals to 0, and where the complex slope of this line is defined by minus a upon a bar. Let us say we have two lines with complex slope alpha 1 and alpha 2. Now for these two lines to be perpendicular, that is for these two lines with slope alpha 1 and alpha 2 to be perpendicular, we say that alpha 1 plus alpha 2 should be equal to 0,
and if these two lines are parallel, then alpha 1 should be equals to alpha 2. Once again, what I am telling is, if I have two lines with complex slope alpha 1 and alpha 2, for alpha 1 and alpha 2 to be perpendicular, the summation of their slopes has to be 0, and for alpha 1 and alpha 2 to be parallel, their two slopes has to be equal. I am just extending the same concept here. For example, I have two lines of the form A1 Z bar plus A1 bar Z plus B equals to be 0, and the second line A2 Z bar plus A2 bar Z plus B equals to 0. Now, for these two lines to be perpendicular, minus A1 upon A1 bar plus minus A2 upon A2 bar has to be equal to 0, which gives us minus A1 A2 bar minus A2 A1 bar has to be equal to 0. I am taking out the minus sign, so we get is A1 A2 bar plus A2 A1 bar has to be equal to 0. And for these two lines to be parallel, I say the two slopes have to be equal. This implies minus A1 upon A1 bar should be equal to minus A2 upon A2 bar, which gives me A1 A2 bar minus A2 A1 bar should be equal to 0. This is the condition for two lines to be perpendicular, and this is the condition for two lines to be parallel. One more important thing, if I have a line joining two points, two complex numbers Z1 and Z2, then the complex slope of that line, then the complex slope of line Z1 Z2 is given by Z1 minus Z2 upon Z1 bar minus Z2 bar. I am repeating once again, what I am telling is, if you have a line joining two points, two complex points Z1 and Z2, the complex slope of the line Z1 Z2 is given by Z1 minus Z2 divided by Z1 bar minus Z2 bar. Now I am trying to derive a corollary from this. I have three points A Z1, B Z2 and C Z3. If this, if by these three points A, B and C are collinear, this means that the slope of AB, complex slope of AB would be equal to complex slope of BC, would be equal to complex slope of AC. So I can always write complex slope of AB equals to complex slope of BC equals to complex slope of AC, which from this equation would be Z1 minus Z2 upon Z1 bar minus Z2 bar is equals to Z2 minus Z3 upon Z2 bar minus Z3 bar is equals to Z1 minus Z3 is equals to Z1 bar minus Z3 bar. This is the condition for three points Z1, Z2 and Z3 to be collinear. What we have done was, what we have done is, first we derived the complex slope of a line joining two points Z1 and Z2, and then we said that for if these two, three points are collinear, then the slope of AB would be equal to slope of BC, which will be equal to slope of EC, AC. We have written the complex slope of AB, BC and AC, and we have equated them. So this is the condition for three points ABC to be collinear. So under this topic, that is equation of straight lines, we have seen lots of things. The first thing was how we could derive the general equation for a straight line in parametric form. So in parametric form, The equation of straight line turned out to be tz1 plus 1 minus tz2 equals to z.
This was the parametric equation for the straight line.
When we said that the non-parametric equation of a straight line can be derived by solving this determinant z, z bar 1, z1, z bar 1 and z2, z2 bar 1 equals to 0.
This was the equation of a straight line in non-parametric form.
Then we derive the general equation of a straight line, which could be always written in the form of az bar plus az, a bar z plus b
equals to 0. From this, we said that the complex slope of a straight line can always be written as minus a upon a bar, and the real slope of a line can be written as real of a minus of real of a upon imaginary of a. Then we said if two lines with slope complex of alpha 1 and alpha 2 are perpendicular, then alpha 1 plus alpha 2 has to be equal to 0, and if they are parallel, then alpha 1 should be equal to alpha 2. This is the condition which we derive for two lines to be perpendicular and two lines to be parallel. Then we even define if we have a line joining two complex points z1 and z2, then the slope of this line is given by z1 minus z2 upon z1 bar minus z2 bar, and this is the condition that we derive for 3 points z1, z2 and z3 to be collinear. Now let us solve one question based upon equation of straight line, that we can, we will try to apply all the concepts that we have learned till now. So we have to solve this question. The question is, if A dash is the reflection of point A with respect to the line ZB plus Z bar P plus C equals to 0, we have to show that A dash B plus A bar B plus C equals to 0. This is the same type of question we have proved in case of inverse of a point. Now we will try to prove the same question by applying the concept of straight line. So we have given that A dash is the reflection of A with respect to this line. So let us try to plot the equation, complete situation. This is our line, which is the that is ZB plus Z bar B plus C equals to 0. This is our point A and this is our point A dash. Now we are given that A is the reflection of A dash with respect to this line. Now, since this line is the perpendicular bisector of the line joining A and A dash, the midpoint of A, A dash must lie on this line, that is ZB bar plus Z bar B plus ZC equals to 0. By section formula, we know that the midpoint of A line joining A and A bar, A dash, is A plus A dash divided by 2. This point must lie on this, this point must lie on this line with this equation. So I can say that A plus A dash by 2 must satisfy this equation. So we can write A plus A dash by 2 into B plus A plus A dash conjugate divided by 2 plus B. I think this should be Z B bar. So here we will get the equation is ZB bar, and here we will put ZB bar, because the general equation is always in the form of AZ bar plus A bar Z plus C B equals to 0. So this should be B bar. So A plus A dash by 2 B bar plus A plus A dash bar by 2 B plus C equals to 0. This is the first equation which we got by using the property of perpendicular bisector. The next thing which we know is these two lines should be perpendicular, since this line is the perpendicular bisector. So I can say that the slope of this line joining A and A dash and the slope of this perpendicular bisector, the summation of the slope of these two has to be 0. So the complex slope of line joining A and A dash would be A minus A dash plus A bar minus A dash bar, and the slope of this line is going to be the coefficient of z bar divided by coefficient of z, that is minus b plus b bar has to be 0. This is your equation 2. When we will solve these two equations, we will get the result that we want to obtain, that is a bar b plus a dash b c. Let us try to solve this. What we will have to do is we have to subtract equation 2 from equation 1. On subtracting these two equations, we are going to get the result that we have to obtain. Now let us study one more thing along with the equation of straight line, that is the distance of a point, that is the distance of a point from a straight line. So say I have a point z1 and I have a line represented by a bar z plus a z bar plus b equals to 0, and what I have to do is I have to find the perpendicular distance of this point z1 with this line a bar z plus a z bar plus b equals to 0. Now remember what we used to do in case of complex number. In case of complex number, we used to put z1 b equals to 0. In case of complex number, if there was a point xy and there was a line ax plus by plus c equals to 0, we used to say that the point x1, that the distance of the point x1 by 1 from line ax plus by plus c equals to 0 was ax1 plus by1 plus c mod of this divided by a square plus b square. We are going to apply a similar concept even in case of complex number, where we say that the distance, we say that the perpendicular distance of z1 from line a bar z plus a z bar plus b equals to 0 is denoted by modulus of a bar z plus, sorry, modulus of a bar z1 plus a z1 bar plus b divided by modulus of a plus modulus of a bar, which is equals to modulus of a bar z1 plus a z1 bar plus b divided by twice of mod a. This is the general formula for deriving perpendicular distance of any point z1 with respect to line a bar z plus a z bar plus b equals to 0. So I think we have studied almost lots of things related to equation of a straight line. We have studied parametric equation of a straight line, non-parametric equation for a straight line, condition for two lines to be parallel, two lines to be perpendicular, and we have even studied how we can find the perpendicular distance of a point with respect to a straight line. Now after discussing this, let us try how we can find general equation of a circle in case of complex numbers. Let us start with our next topic, that is how we can find equation of a circle in case of complex numbers. For example, I have a circle whose center is z0 and whose radius is r. Now, as per the property of a circle, or as per the definition of a circle is a locus of point whose distance from a fixed point, which is called the center of a circle, is always equal to the radius of the circle. Once again, I am repeating, as per the definition of a circle is a locus of a point whose distance from a fixed point, which is called the center of a circle, is always constant, which is equal to the radius of the circle. So, for example, if I have a point, I define any point z which lies on the circle, then as per the property of the circle, z minus z0, that is the distance of this point z from the center, which is always going to be same, which is going to be the radius of the circle. Now, any point
z dash or say z1 dash which lies inside this circle can always be given by z minus z0 less than r. So this equation, that is z minus z0, mod of z minus z0 is less than r, represents any point that lies inside this circle z minus z0 equals to r. It means any point that lies inside the circle z minus z0 equals to r. And similarly, the equation z minus z0 greater than r represents any point that lies outside the circle z minus z0 equals to r. Once again, let us discuss what let us review what we had discussed. We started with the discussion with the general definition for circle, which says that circle is nothing but a locus of point whose distance from a common point that is defined as the center of the circle is always constant, which is equals to the radius of that circle. So using the equation of a circle, we said that any point z must satisfy this equation, that is mod of z minus z0 equals to r, where z0 is the center of the circle and r is the radius of the circle. Now we discussed two more thing, that is we discussed an equation for a point that lies inside this circle. So any point that lies inside this circle must satisfy this equation, that is mod of z minus z0 should be less than r. That is, the distance of this point which lies inside this circle has to be less than r. And similarly, for the point to lie outside the circle, its distance from the center has to be greater than r. Now let us try to find general equation of a circle for complex numbers. So I find the term, the topic is general equation of a circle. In case of complex numbers, the general equation of a circle is given by zz bar plus a bar z plus az bar plus b equals to 0. In this case, a is a complex number and b belongs to any real number. Once again, the general equation of a circle for complex number is given by this equation, that is zz bar plus a bar z plus az bar plus b equals to 0, where a is any complex number and b belongs to real number. For this equation, the center of a circle is defined by minus coefficient of z bar, or which is equals to, in our case, minus a. And radius of the circle is defined by under root of modulus of a square minus b. I suggest you all to note down this general equation and the coordinate, the equation for center and radius based upon this equation, because this is a really important equation, and we are going to use it in lots of questions related to complex number. So general equation of a circle is this: based upon this equation, the center of a circle is minus coefficient of z bar, that is minus a, and the radius of the circle is defined as mod of a square minus b. One really important thing that we have to note down is, in this general equation, the coefficient of zz bar is always 1. So when we and based upon this, we have written that the center is minus a and the radius is under root of a square minus b. So in case, if we are given any general equation of a circle where the coefficient of zz bar is not 1, then we have to make it 1 and then solve this equation. Let us solve one question and try to apply this equation.
So the question is, we are given a general equation of a circle as 2zz bar plus 3 minus iota z plus 3 plus iota z bar minus 7 equals to 0. And we have to find the center and radius for this equation of circle. I am writing the equation more clearly once again. The equation of a circle is twice zz bar 3 minus iota z plus 3 plus iota z bar minus 7 equals to 0. And we have to find the center and radius for this circle. Now comparing these two equations, we know here we know that the coefficient of zz bar is 1, but here it is 2. So let us first make the coefficient of z into z bar as 1. The equation turns out to be z into z bar plus 3 minus iota by 2z plus 3 plus iota divided by 2 into z bar minus 7 equals to 0. Now as per our definition, the center of the circle is minus coefficient of z bar, that is minus a. So your coefficient of z bar is 3 plus iota 2. The center of the circle would be minus of 3 plus iota divided by 2. This is the center of the circle. And the radius of the circle would be under root mod of a, that is mod of 3 plus iota by 2 whole square minus the real part, that is minus 7. This is 9 plus 10, 10 by 2 whole square plus 7. On solving this, we will get the radius of the circle. So now what we have studied is the general equation of a circle, which is given as zz bar plus a bar z plus az bar plus b equals to 0. And whenever we have to find the center and radius of a circle based upon the general equation, the first thing that we have to take care of is the coefficient of z into z bar is equals to 1. After making the coefficient of z and z bar 1, we can say that the circle, center of the circle would be minus coefficient of z bar, and the radius of the circle would be modulus of the a square, modulus of this a, that is the center of the circle, minus the constant term which would be there in the equation, which in this case is b. Now let us try to derive one more equation of a circle based upon